guys, have a good day. I'm Kamayo Ako. Now, I just want to show you that even though we don't have any knowledge concerning Microsoft Access on how to make or how to develop Microsoft Access with a database, but Microsoft Office itself provide us the templates, the free templates that we can download and use it by our personal or in our business. So this is how. First, you need to open here, or here you can open because I already put in the taskbar, or find here, just click. If you are using Windows 8, just this arrow, then you can scroll, then here, this one, Microsoft Access. No, I'm using version 2013. So here, if you say we have a lot of templates with database, here you can choose which you need, either nutrition tracking, call tracking, customer, home inventory, inventory, library. You can choose any meaning. So now I just want to show you sample like here, this one, inventory, which is we can use by personal or we can use also in our business. This is, you can download free. So here you can browse which location you want to. I will put in my desktop and I will rename it with my inventory. So just hit OK, then create. Yeah, so this is how, this is our inventory database. We can close this one, then here, inventory. So this is your database now, you can use freely. So first, here is inventory transaction list. So here item, we don't have yet item, and here also employee. So as of now, no employee. So what we want to do is we need to click this one, employees first, this one, employee. Now this is the list of the employee, so we need to add new employee. So whatever we enter, it will come here. So we'll click new employee here. I will type my old passion name, Corvera. And my email, I can put my this web page one. Okay. I will attach my image, my picture. Okay. This is only sample. So I will, if you click save, now you can add another employee. If I hit close this one, look, my name is already here. So I need to close it. Then I need to insert also a supplier. So new supplier. Like, my R. National hero. See, Lisa. It's only just sample also. We'll save. Close. Now we had a supplier. So I request the supplier. The inventory items. So in inventory items, we don't have yet the items here. So we need to add items. So here, say a canned goods. So here, text you enter this not in the item list. Do you want to edit in the item? Of course, yes. So now we have now this one can. So if you select OK, now in the list can codes is already here. So location. So any location, location 3 example. If you want to be specific. So location and a rack. Number 02. Now we come up with a message box that shown this not is in the list. Look again, we'll make yes, then okay. Now here we have an option enter. Then since we already put the supplier, that's why I show you before. Now if you select this drop down, we can see OZ result. Look, this is now manufacturer. So manufacturer, let's say I just put a sample to reorder level. So I will put this one is 50. Then target stock level, let's say 75. So description is can goods export can goods. So I will save it. So now we have a can goods. So I will put now, since we have already a category, so we need to put a item. So which item that belongs to can goods? So let's say tuna flakes. So this is the one, tuna flakes, a 100 grams. So now we have a list of items. So we will close. So now this is the transaction. If you select the item here, you can see tuna flakes. So automatically this one will show every time we choose the items. Now since I already put an employee, so now my name is here. So just type quantity 100, let's say 150. Then now the actual quantity is 50. So it's the same process. If you need to add another items, so you can add here, then new inventory, category is junk foods here, location, if you say yes, then okay. So junk foods, now location is rack number 03. So supplier, it's a rack number 3, then the same supplier. Save for samples, stock level 50, reorder 50, then stock level 75 as our default. This one is local items. Then you can put here comment or any here. So local items. So you see save. Then close. Now we have jumpers. Then we put here a Dositos, because I cannot tell any products, maybe it's a prohibited, so I will just put the Dositos 30 grams. So I will close this one. So now we have already a reorder level and stock level 75. Close. Now if you choose in the inventory transaction, I'm gonna put here Tuna Flakes. Here Doritos, and same here my name, then quantity 25. So now the total is 75. So this is our inventory here. So this is how to use the free templates which provided by the Microsoft Office. So thank you and God bless.